Hey, Bio One students, Mr. Yass again. We're going to kind of skip ahead to Roman numeral 5 in notes, just so I can get your foldable done so we can take our test coming up here since we're kind of running out of days here at the end of the year. So this is Roman numeral 5. We're going to talk about Charles Darwin and some evidence of why he came up with this theory, what supports it. This is science, so we got to have stuff to back up what we say. So if you guys remember, Charles Darwin talked about organisms changing over time. And these occur by natural selection. That five-part theory I talked about is what's important, the survival of the fittest. The ones that have the best traits survive, pass those traits on. So what are some things that they throw out there as evidence? Let's look at his finches. So you'll see us a lot in the next couple of days of notes. He was studying these finches. He noticed that all these over here were ones only found in the Galapagos Islands. You don't find them anywhere else in the world. And the thought is it came from this original ancestor from the mainland, and then it evolved into all these different birds down the road. So he came up with some of these pieces of the puzzle, if you want to look at it that way. What are some evidences that suggest that maybe we come from a common ancestor? Okay. So one argument is homologous structures. Homologous structures are body parts that have the same basic structure, but they don't have the same function. I think that's a big key. Okay, so similar function or have the same structure but different functions. Okay, and let me show you something here real quick while I'm on this subject. So what I want you to do is if I have something in red. So here's homologous structures. We're going to open up the tab, and we're going to put on the back of that tab, see if you can see this. Get my camera down here. On the back of it, you'll put what I have in red. Across from it, in the middle of your foldable, you'll put what's in yellow. So examples, definition. Example, definition. So that's how we're going to finish up both sides of our foldable, okay? So you're going to see a lot of stuff in red and a lot of stuff in yellow. And there's some things that don't have examples. You may just have a definition on the back of your tab, okay? So I'm going to show you some extreme examples here. Let's look at some very different organisms, a bird, a horse, a whale. We're going to use these bones for different purposes, right? The whale swimming, the lion running, lion and horse, humans grasping objects, a bird for flight, right? But yet, even though they have different functions, they're homologous organs because they have the same structure. They all have a humerus. They all have an ulna and a radius, phalanges. That's what these bones are. And that kind of shows that maybe somewhere back on their ancestral tree, were they related? Did they have a common ancestor? Now, understand, I like to show both sides of this issue. Understand that it doesn't mean that a horse has 206 bones like we do, or a whale has 206 bones. The rest of their body may be different, but at least this part of their body is similar, and that's where they come up with an evidence that supports this common ancestry thing. All right? Let's look at something totally different. Let's go a different direction. Let's say we have vestigial organs. These are organs that have no structures, that have no function now, but they're still there. Hip bones in a snake and a whale, the appendix in a human. I love this picture of the star nose mole and how he lives underground. He has no eyes, but yet he has eye sockets where eyes used to be. Okay, and what evolution is going to tell you is why do they still have those things? Why do we have an appendix? We don't use it anymore. Why does a whale have a hip bone? I mean, can you imagine a whale walking across outside? That would be interesting, down the streets of Ligonier. Why do they still have that? That just because it's a remnant. It's left over from maybe their prehistoric days where maybe they had legs, right? So that's another strong evidence of evolution. Why do we have vestigial organs still today? Well, why are they there? That's another evidence that supports that theory, okay? Let's look at embryology. Embryology, you can see here that especially in the beginning, here's a fish, salamander, chicken, rabbit, human. Most of us are going to agree, not a lot of connections there today. with ancestral trees. But yet, if you look at the bottom pictures, we have a tail, we have gill slits. We look very, very eerily familiar, right? Similar. And why is that? Because of an ancestral, common ancestor type of thing, all right? And the last one, this will finish up the left side of your foldable, is biochemistry. Let's take chemistry and bio and let's put them together. Why does every living thing on the planet have DNA? And it's the same DNA. It's the same four bases. It's deoxyribose and phosphate. We have same amino acids that make up our proteins, but yet we're all a very diverse world that we live in of different species. These similar genetic codes, these similar DNA sequences and so forth, that suggests that maybe, again, there is some link to a common ancestor someday. And this is kind of showing you a baboon, a chimp, a lemur, a gorilla, and human, which are on the same primate family, but yet look at the different sequencing, right? And some of them are very similar. There are some differences if you look closely, but there are some similarities as well, okay? So those are just things that suggest that maybe there's some common ancestry. This is your whole left side or foldable, so you can go ahead and fill that out. And then tomorrow's notes, I'll put in the other side, and then this is what we're going to use on the test. So your entire test is going to come from this foldable, okay? So please fill it out. Make sure that you get that stuff in there so that we do good on my last test, all right? Hey, as always, if you got questions, shoot me an email. And have a great day. See you. Bye.